So the reports are that we caught Gaddafi. Big deal. What do we get out of it? They have the oil. The rebels would have given us everything if we had some leader that knew how to negotiate. The rebels were being routed 4 months ago, absolutely routed by Gaddafi and his men. And you even see, even with all of our support and all of the support of NATO, which is essentially us, it was very hard to crack them. So here's what happens. We spend billions and billions and billions of dollars. We just absolutely blast the hell out of them. The rebels then go in, take over the place, and now if we ask for oil, they give us nothing. They say they're great rebels, they're great freedom fighters, we deserve nothing. If 4 months ago, when they were being routed and just beaten badly and ready to give up, if we would have said we want 50% of the oil, they would have said, absolutely, you have a deal, help us, please, you have a deal. What do we get? We get nothing. If Obama would have backed the people of Iran 2 years ago, when that country had a big, big problem and the protesters were really making headway, like he backs the protesters in the United States, as they call themselves, Occupy, we wouldn't have any problems right now in Iran. Believe me, that country would have been turned over so fast. Instead, he abandoned those people, and you know what the end result is, and Iran has only gotten stronger. The man doesn't know what he's doing. On top of everything else, the misery index has just risen to a 28-year high. That's unemployment plus inflation. It's called misery. It's a misery index. It's at an all-time high, folks. Is Obama really going to be elected? And then median income has fallen to the lowest level of this century. We're talking century, less than $27,000, about $507 a week. It's never been that way relatively for this century. What are we doing? Are we going to keep this guy in office?